Good morning all. In the series of lectures of BAC second year, the third topic is bilateral continuous programming distribution, and this is the second lecture on based on this topic. Today, let me see what is marginal probability distribution. So, do you know what it means, the word marginal? So, marginal is nothing but singular. The name of the topic is bilateral, that means you are studying the bilateral continuous probability distribution. And then we have two dimensions this time. One is the joint linear set of x comma. Now for our study, if we need the distribution of x alone or distribution of y alone, then what is the procedure? So the definition marginal probability distribution gives me the distribution of x alone or distribution of y alone. Fine. So let me study. Let x comma y be a bilateral continuous random neighbor with a joint median f of x comma y. Now the marginal probability distribution of x is f1x is equal to integration over the range of other variables, that is y f of x comma y dy. So this is the marginal period of x, that is the distribution of x alone. Over here, we can take the integration over the other variables. Since it is marginal period of x, we can take the integration over y. And the marginal period of y is, that means we zero we can follow x to y. Then we will integration over x, f of x comma y dx. So these are the two marginal periods of x and y. Respectively. So, marginal is nothing but we can find the single distribution or single random variable distribution. Okay, so let me find again. Let x comma y be a bilateral continuous random variable with joint linear f of x comma y. Now, the marginal probability distribution of x alone is, do you know that as f1x or you can as fx only. Okay, so fx is equal to integration over the range of y. F of x comma y dy. That is the marginal distribution of x alone. Now the marginal distribution of y is x to y, which is equal to integration over x, f of x comma y dx. So that is the marginal period of x and y. Now let me have an example based on this marginal period. So example is let me have given a probability density function or joint density function of x comma y as c y minus x, and the range of over here the range is in this manner, okay, and is equal to 0 otherwise. Getting it? So that means the range of x is dependent on y, which is 0 to y, and the range of y is dependent on x, and the range is x to 1. Getting the concept? That means the range of x and y both are dependent on the other variable. X depends on y and y depends on x. That means this range is called as dependent range. And we have two types of ranges, dependent range and independent range. If the range is independent, then the problem solving method is or taking the range is different. And if the range is dependent, then the problem solving when we take the range is different. So if the range is in this manner, see, that means the ranges are different. So they are independent of each other. They are independent of each other. If we take 0 minus infinity to infinity, we take any, okay, but they are not dependent on each other. So that means this is dependent, sorry, independent range, and this is my independent range. Okay. Over here we need to find the value of c and marginal period of x. Marginal period of x only. Okay, so let me find it. So we have to find c. We know that since the given function is joint probability density function, hence we know that since it is joint probability density function, it must satisfy the condition as xy f of x comma y dx dy. Equal to 1. Okay, now observe. We can replace the value of x comma y. That is c y minus x dx dy is equal to 1. Now the most important part is how we take the range. one. Okay. I may solve this. I may solve this by using this procedure. See, I may solve this by using this procedure. So, here divide here. Okay. This is all. Now, since over here I can get dy, you can get the range of y, which is dependent on x. And the range of y dependent on x is this, that is x to 1. And the range of x is independent, which is 0 to 1. One and the same. Both the integrals if we solve, we get the same answer for c, constant c. Okay? But I will solve this procedure. Okay, so that means, therefore, c, we have in the integral, which is with respect to x. Hence, we can take y as constant and we can take the integration. So, what is the integration over here? It is yx minus x squared divided by 2 dy. And the range is 0 to y is equal to 1. Okay? So, now let me solve this. So, to solve this, we have c integration and the range is 0 to 1. Okay? 0 to 1. And we can take the value of x as 1. Not the value of y. It is the value of x as 1. So over here y, that means the y squared minus, you mean x squared, you can put the value of x as y, that means this is y squared by 2, minus y squared by 2 dy is equal to 1. Now, again for the integral, which is equal to 1, okay, so y cube divided by 3, minus, I have y cube divided by 3 into 2, that is 6, 0 to 1 is equal to 1. So, c, what we have now, so c, I have 6, 2y cube minus y cube is equal to 1. So, that means I have c divided by 6, 0 to 1, okay. So, now put the value of y as 1 over here, what we get, and 0, otherwise. So, 2y cube minus y cube, means it gives me y cube divided by 6, y cube divided by 6 for 0 to 1. So, put the value of y as 1, what we get? 1 divided by 6. 1 divided by 6. So what we get? C divided by 6 is equal to 1, and hence the value of C is 6. Value of C is 6. Okay. Now, let me find. That means your joint density function is 6, y minus 6. Isn't it? Now, let me find the marginal distribution of x. So, marginal distribution of x. So, to find the marginal distribution, the formula is f1x, the range of y, f of x, comma y, b, 1. So, that means it is range of y, the range of y is x to 1. Over here, since the range is dependent, we can get the dependent range. So, x to 1, and we have f of x, comma y, that is x, y minus x, b, 1. Now, solve this integral, what we get? So, y squared divided by 2 minus xy for the range is 1. Now, we can put the value, range of y, value of y as 1 or value of y as 6. So, what we get? So, half minus x squared divided by 2 minus plus x squared. Okay? Fine. So, this is equal to now what we get. So, f1x is equal to 6. Into that case, what we have? Half minus 6 minus x squared divided by 2 plus x squared. That means minus x squared divided by 2 plus x squared using x squared divided by 2. Hence what we have? Half minus x plus x squared divided by 2. So, multiply the equation. Now we may get 2. So, 1 minus 2x plus x squared. So, this gives me 3. So, 3 times x squared minus 2x plus 1. So, this can be written as x squared minus 2x plus 1. That means I have x minus 1 bracket squared. Okay? So, that is the simplification. This is my f1x. Which contains, since it is a marginal variable x, it has only one random variable x. Okay? So, and the value of x obviously is in 0 to 1. Now we can write independent range, not dependent, okay? X 0 to 1, 0, otherwise. So that is the answer for marginal PDF of X, otherwise. Marginal PDF of X. a alum. Now, let me have the next definition, that is conditional probability distribution. So, you know the concept of conditional, isn't it? In FYPNC only, you know what is conditional probability distribution, okay? So, in the similar manner, I can define conditional probability distribution, okay? So, let me have x, y as the bimodal continuous random variable with joint periods f of x, y. Now, the marginal, conditional probability distribution of x given y denoted as g1x given y is equal to y, or we may have g1x given y. So this is defined as given x given y is f of x, y divided by f to y. Over here, f to y is strictly not equal to 0. F to y, since bigger is 0, then the value of probability is given to infinity. So, f of x, y is 2y, and x to y is strictly greater than 0. That means it is not equal to 0. Okay, so that means it is the x given y. Or if I need to write y given x, then it is g2 y given x. This is equal to f of x, y divided by marginal of this given quantity. So, f1x, or you can have f x. And obviously, f1x is strictly greater than 0. f1x is strictly greater than 0. Now let me solve the example, or let me define it again and then we solve one example of conditional probability. So, let x, y be a bimodal continuous random variable with joint period f of x, y. Now, the conditional probability distribution of x given y denoted as g1 x given y is equal to y. Let's say over here the value of y is given to you. Okay, and by considering the condition, you can find the distribution of x. That is condition. So g1x given y. This is equal to f of x, y divided by f to y. Over here, f to y is strictly not equal to 0 of f to y greater than 0. Again, g2y given x is equal to f of x, y divided by f1x. f1x is greater than 0. So that is the marginal probability, that is the conditional probability distribution of x given y or y given x. Now, let me have one example for finding this conditional probability. So the example is, if x, y is a bimodal continuous random variable which joint period is 2 minus x minus y and the range becomes, the range is x less than y, this is x, y, 0 to 1, is equal to 0 the range. So this range is not dependent range. Since the time is between these two random variables, time is common, that means the range is in this manner. See, observe, okay, the range is in this manner, but they are written in this manner, okay. So this is not a dependent range, it is independent range. So let me solve this. Fine. So to solve this, I need to find the marginal of x given y as well as marginal of y given x. So to solve this, so marginal of x given y, formula for this is f of x, y, we have x to y. Okay. So that means I need to find marginal. Marginal of y as well as marginal of x. So first of all, we find marginal. So marginal of x, so f1x is equal to, so let me write over here, so this is f1x. f1x is equal to integration over x, f of, integration over y, f of x, y, dy. So this is equal to integration over y. So the range of y is constant, which is 0 to 1. F of x, y is this, that is 2 minus x minus y, dy. So this is equal to now, we have to take the integration y. So 2y minus xy minus y square by 2 is 0 to 1. Okay. So that means I have f1x is equal to what we have. Now put the value of y as 1 and value of y as 0. So I can put the value of y as 1 equal. So 2 minus we have put the value of y as 1. So x minus half. Okay. And since equal to 0, I can get anything. So the answer over here is 2 whatever. So that is my marginal of x. Now to find the conditional, the g1x given, sorry, g2y given. g2y given x is equal to f of x comma y divided by f1x. This is the formula for marginal of y given x. Okay, so g2y given x now, this is equal to f of x comma y, that is the g1 and g2. Okay, so 2 minus x minus y divided by f1x, and f1x is this. So we can simply replace the value. That means it is 2 times 2 minus x minus y upon I have 3 minus 2x. Okay, so that is the marginal of y given x. Over here, if you observe, since x is given, I can put the value of x over here. And we can write the range of y as 0 to 1 is equal to 0. So this is the conditional parameter distribution of y given x. We can write in this manner. Okay? That's y given x. Now, let me find the conditional parameter distribution of x given y. So to find this, we need to find, first of all, x to y. So x to y, that is integration over the range of x, f of x comma y, dx. So this is equal to 0 to 1, 2 minus x minus y, dx. So this gives me actually both the marginals are same for the ranges are same. Okay, so this gives me 2x minus x squared divided by 2 minus yx is 0 to 1. So this is equal to 2 minus half minus 1 minus y. So 0, no. Okay? So we can put the value of x only. So x is 1, 2 minus half minus 1. Okay, so this gives me, no, I think the answer is somewhat different. So what is it? So 2, we have 4 minus 1 minus 2y. So now what we get? So f2y is equal to what we have. 4 minus 1, that is 3. So 3, no, same answer. 3 minus 2y divided by 2, and the range of y is 0 to 1. So this is marginal. Now to find conditional, we have g1x given y is equal to f of x comma y divided by f to y. That means this f of x comma y is 2 minus x minus y. So simply put the value. 2 minus x minus y divided by f2y, f2y is this. So that means 3 minus 2y divided by 2. So the simplification of v is 2 minus x minus y upon 3 minus 2y, and we can put over here this y is constant. We can put the range of x over there. And the range of x is 0 to 1. Is equal to 0. Okay. So in today's lecture, we have seen what is the definition of marginal probability distribution, and we have an example based on this. Again, we have a second definition as conditional probability distribution of both, that is x given y and y given x, and we have an example based on this.